If there's anything else you can remember or anything you want to talk to us about.
I think that's about it, sir. I got statements from all the other kids.
Why aren't you telling us?
Sir.
What's the story with Harper and Wheeler?
Well, they went to talk to the suspect's parents. They had a warrant.
I already know that. Why haven't we heard back?
Well, that's what I'm trying to tell you. They called in 15 minutes ago.
What do the parents have to say?
Sir, the parents are dead. Multiple gunshot wounds. They were still in bed. Homicides on the scene. The final count of the school was 6 decedents, 2 wounded in the hospital, 1 critical. Same weapon used in both locations.
Shooter's dead. The parents are dead. We got nothing.
Yes, sir.
What about the girl?
Well, actually, that's the other thing I want to talk to you about. She still hasn't said a word. Her name is Alicia Browning. She was standing directly next to the perpetrator when Attack Officer Parker took his shot. It was messy.
Yeah, I saw.
We brought her straight here, but like I said, she's hardly spoken a word. Look, you might have better luck.
When I was in the high school, there was this kid. Paul Ashley was his name. I hated him. I mean, I really despised the guy. So one day I decided I was going to do something about it. We ended up throwing punches in back of the field house after school. I gave him a black eye. He broke my nose.
You can hardly tell.
I remember that when my parents found out, they went ballistic. I was grounded for a month, ended up losing a girlfriend over it.
What happened to Paul Ashley?
We became best friends. This boy today was packing a Tech 9 semi-automatic with hollow point rounds and 2 clips to spare. Perpetrators, decedents. High school is no place for kids anymore.
Can I buy my smoke?
Wait a minute. How old are you?
Give me a cigarette and I'll tell you.
Alicia, my name is Martin Van Zandt. I'm chief detective for the county, and I got an awful mess on my hands. I really need you to help me here. I want you to understand that you are not under arrest and there are no charges pending. I looked you up, and I guess you probably know that you've got a file. There's an outstanding shoplifting complaint against you, but we're going to overlook that for now. Having said that, we've taken a number of statements today which have caused us to leave you here for the duration. Statements that seem to confirm that you and the suspect in question were acquainted. Is that correct?
Look, did he tell you? Did you know this was going to happen today?
Hey, let's slow it down, okay? But Alicia, I need you to know that if you were aware of this in advance and didn't say anything, you could get in a lot of trouble. Not shoplifting trouble. Real damn trouble. Look, as much as anything else, we just want to know why You knew this, kid. You might be able to help us make some sense out of this whole thing.
And in point of fact, this young man's grades were very good. And that's always the weirdest part about these things. Common sense would have you think that the troubled kid would pull stuff like this, a kid with a temper, but it never happens like that, does it? It's never the bully.
Of course not. Bullies have to graduate so they can become police officers. How about it, Detective Martin Van Zandt? You ever pick a fight in high school? Because I would bet almost anything that you did.
Alicia, did you know what was going to happen? If I find out different, if I... Please don't let me find out different.
Can I go now?
Sure.
Why the hell did you do that?
She's got something to tell us. She just wants to do it on her own.
Bullshit, Martin. What the hell was that?
I want to know more about her. Pull her school records. You know the drill.
Yes, sir. So understand the attitude of some of these kids. I think they can tell us anything like we don't get it. Not as stupid as she thinks we are.
Right. By the way, how much did that lighter cost you?
Good evening. Another high school shooting, this time in our own backyard. Police have now confirmed...